Ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to the Brothers Bear Podcast live on the Rant Radio Network. Don't go anywhere, kiddies. You wouldn't want to make the Joker sad, would you?
Ay, ese compadre, eso dice... ¡Un, dos, tres, cuatro! Hey guys, welcome back to the Brothers Bear Podcast. Thank you for tuning in. If it's your first time, second time, third time, fourth, fifth, or whatever time you think it is for you.
Last.
After that intro, it's going to be their last.
Oh, the Brothers Bear, the Brothers Bear. There's something rare today in this Brothers Bear episode.
Were you rhyming on purpose?
A little bit.
Were you reading some Dr. Seuss books?
This guy sounds like it.
Brothers Bear. I wonder who would care.
For my rhyming of the Brothers Bear. I didn't get that. I thought I had something.
But honestly, something is missing, though.
What is missing, bro?
I don't...
Can you see it?
Can you see what is missing? Something.
Oh, I know who.
What
is missing? Our brother.
The actual brother.
Bear.
The brother's bear.
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 Mr. Sanch.
Sanch is missing for the first time ever.
Santos, I miss you.
Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time, we've been doing the show for 3 years.
3 years, bro.
3 years. 3 years. And there's been a handful of episodes where I'm missing, and then both my brother and
the guest host here.
And it's been you two, you know, and then there's been a handful of episodes where it's just myself and him. But there's never in these 3 years of recording has there ever been, or even going live, has there been an episode
with no Sanch.
With no Sanch. So today in history, in the Brothers Bear Network history, in the iRant radio history of going live, it's the first Sanchless episode.
Sanchless.
A moment of silence.
Santos, I miss you so much.
We miss you.
You always will be in my heart.
Our hearts.
Never gonna go from here. I don't even know what I'm singing. I'm gonna stop that. Honestly, that was pretty good. I know. But
hey, can you play it again? Did you record us doing that? Well, I mean, it's recorded regardless.
He got no playback style.
Not yet.
Too good. That's too good of a stuff right there for him. For DJ Slim. He's like, hey, I can only do so much here.
Big shout out to DJ Slim for helping us today.
Big shout outs, which will bring you to... Oh, man, it didn't go right. Oh, there we go. Yay.
Brothers Bear Podcast.
Big shout outs go right here real quick to the main college here, to our friends out in Mount Sierra.
Mount Sierra College.
College.
If it wasn't for you, we'd be in the ditch, dead and soulless.
Mm-hmm.
But we're not, so thank you.
But wait, we got more.
We got more?
Yes, we do.
This is another shout out.
Another shout out and another sponsor of the Brothers Bear Podcast. And thank you. And soon our second live episode will be at
Hattie Ho Comics. DJ Slim put that image right up there. for the folks. Not mine. There you go.
Heidi Ho.
So the Brothers Bear is going to be at the Heidi Ho comic store, and I am freaked the fuck out. you know me. I don't like that. Mm-mm. That kind of thing, that liveness, but it's going to be great. It's going to be fun. There's comics there. There's going to be entertainment. We have stuff to give away.
Yeah. It's actually going to be a lot of fun. We have a lot of surprises. I'm still planning some things I'm going to be doing right after the live podcast. Possible gig, as in stand-up. Ooh. So, did I just hint something?
Did you hint something really well, too? Oh, my God.
So, maybe not only are we going to get our laughs from us three, but possibly a good set from some comedians, counting myself. Stay tuned.
My palms are itchy. Wait, that means for something else, huh? Never mind. Never mind you that.
can we talk about the first time we ever went live?
Sure. Right now, since we're talking about that, yes. Yeah. And the Heidi Ho Comics Brothers Bear edition, it will be our second live performance, but we have done this once before.
Yeah, for fans that have been sticking with us since the beginning,
knows what's up.
In 2012 we did, and we mentioned this briefly last time we went live, last time we did a show. I want to know, like, all right, now knowing that we have a live show coming up, like, how do you feel right now, like, knowing that, like, it's in 2 weeks?
What was the question?
Like, how do you feel?
How do I feel about it? Yeah. Well, like I said, I'm freaking out. The first time we did it, I did the same thing. I freaked out. Give shout outs to, was it Kirby's house?
Yeah, Kirby.
That Kirby's pad in the backyard, like if it was a backyard gig.
Yeah, we're probably the only ones that has ever done a live
backyard
podcast. Yeah, like, you've heard of gigs, now there's stand-up comedy shows in backyards. There's a handful of things, but I want to say we're probably the only ones ever to do a live podcast in front of an audience.
Yeah, and it was close to the end of 2012, right?
Yeah, it was our end of the world live podcast show.
Which was perfect for me, man. I was all about that. I was all into it. I'm like, oh, my God, the prophecy says that my penis is going to get really large, and it's really going to just destroy the whole world. I'm sorry. That's the wrong Mayan calendar I read.
Imagine that really happened.
I'm sure there's one for it.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
I wouldn't doubt it.
They got so many calendars.
There is.
To, you know, prophesy stuff.
But I remember you kept, like, we were setting up and you kept coming back and forth. You're walking in and out.
Oh, pacing?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And I've known you for quite, like, some time now. And I was like, oh, how is he going to do this? Because, one, I'm used to being in front of an audience when it comes to stand, like, comedy gigs. Like, if it's a bar, you know, a little small hole in the walls plus actual audiences in comedy clubs, you know, like, mm-hmm. big crowds. So I hadn't had no, like, I was like, I was still nervous.
You were cash about it. Yeah.
Like, I could do this, you know? But you, I kept looking at you. I was like, I didn't know what to tell you to be like, hey, dude, we're going to be good. You know, it's just a backyard gig. Like, don't worry. And you disappeared for a while. And I didn't know. Is it true that you actually threw up too?
Yeah, I gagged. I threw up a little. It was a little throw up, but it was mostly gagging. Oh. Like, you know, I got really high, though, too, at the same time. So I was kind of shaking that off.
Yeah.
It was just a bad circumstance for me. In general, it was my first time doing something like that. So I don't know how I'll go about it.
Yeah.
You know, I didn't go to acting school. The only acting I've ever done was backyard wrestling.
Oh.
Right? Because it was wrestling.
Yeah.
You know what wrestling's all about, folks?
Which
it's out
do
the
it.
Bag, right? That's fake, right?
Yeah, wait, what?
I'm not offending anybody, am I?
Someone I'm out like, there is like,
shut the fuck. Nah, I'm a big wrestling fan, so.
Oh, but we will actually be having a wrestling episode in the near future.
Oy. So all things wrestling, and we'll show some clips of me going crazy, mm-hmm. when I was young, and I'm sure that's really enjoyable for the people. Be like, oh my God, what a fucking idiot. Good times.
But I mean, overall, that live episode actually happened to be a really fun one. Like, mm-hmm. it turned out good. I was surprised of how our turnout was really, like, it came out well.
Shout out to everybody who turned out.
Everybody that went.
It was the longest shout out, but we're going to keep going with it.
And not only that, it was cold, too. Mm-hmm. We were just like,
ooh. Yeah, and they chilled out there.
I remember I was wearing a Santa Claus costume. That's what kept me warm.
All right, well, talking about the whole awkwardness, can you imagine the awkwardness on the other side where the people are just watching us doing it, you know, for the first time? You know, it's never been done before, so it's kind of strange
for
the other end as well.
Also, too, the awkwardness of, hey, we're doing a live show. Here's the address of some random person's house that you've never met or been to. It wasn't a gig. It was just, hey, we're going to do a podcast live. Yeah. And then, like, all right, bye. Like, we didn't charge for it. We didn't do it like a normal backyard gig. It was just like, show up. We had chairs set up. We have like a backdrop. It was a red backdrop, red tape. It was just red, everything. And then
it was a dope hangout after. It was. Chilled some vibes. Yeah, it was pretty dope. I enjoyed it. At the end, I was glad it happened, especially the turnout and how other people were responsive to what we were doing.
That's good.
Because it was very, very fucking strange. I remember one of my biggest things was saying that was the most fucking strangest thing that's ever happened to me at that point in my life.
But honestly, in the end, it was a memory.
It was very fond memory.
I'm gonna cherish in my chest and my heart and for everything.
Forever.
It's a story to tell, and that's what I love. And now I just told it right now. We just told it.
We revisited the beauty of live performance.
But we're still on shout-outs, and I do want to give another shout-out.
Give another shout-out,
before I get into those shout-outs, honestly, I want to give a big shout-out to the girlfriend, who I'm pretty sure is watching. And you're watching me. A big shout-out to my girlfriend for actually motivating me, for being a part of what happened this past weekend.
What happened this past weekend, bro?
I'll tell you what happened.
You tell me.
I mean, it wasn't at Tahoe, but the Spartan race happened.
Holy shit, I got the wrong one.
Thanks. I was like, life. Right. Yeah, the Spartan race.
Close to it.
The Spartan race happened this past weekend right there in Temecula.
Temecula.
And for a couple of months now, I've been training for this monster of a beast. If you don't know
what you're training, dude.
That was a moment right there. That was a moment of me just being like, I did this.
Oh, this was the after then.
Yeah, this is the after.
It looked like you were training. My bad, dude.
I have a banana in my hand, too, dude. They're like, eat the banana. That was the most tastiest banana I've ever had. There we go. That's my girlfriend right there.
Oh, how cute. Shout out to the girl, the Carlos's girl. I got all the respect for you, Carlos. Just make sure you don't make me look like a fool out there.
I look all mad. I was like, I just want to sit down.
So it was a race?
It was a race of endurance. It wasn't like a race endurance. I mean, there are some people that are out there that are like running like, whew, I walked almost. Like, man, just going up these damn hills and these obstacles. I mean, if you don't know what the Spartan race is, it's a 5 mile, thingy-majingy.
Thingy-majinger.
Not only that,
is it like mountain climbing?
Yeah, it's mountain. Like going terrain. Uphill, going uphill, downhill. But on top of that, it's not just like a hiking trail, running trail, any of that. You're doing obstacles along the way as well.
Oh, like the wheels on the floor where you put your feet through them?
Wheels on the floor? What are you talking about?
Yeah, you know, like those big tires.
Tires. Yeah. Well, in our race, we didn't have that, but there's some where you got to like lift up one of those like monster truck things and kind of flip it over and then got to bring it back. Like, certain ones have, like, I was watching other videos of Spartan races where they do that. Like, I did the most basic one. There's three races, which is the beginning one, which is sprint, that's the one I did on Sunday. The next one would be super, and then each level increases. So, the beginning one, will, you know, you got your 5 mile. I think the next one is about 8, 10 miles. And then the last one, I want to say, is from, like, 15, 16 miles or so. Plus the obstacle courses increase as well, so it really is a challenge, and also too it really it's a teamwork effort. You know, I think that's what I enjoyed about
it. You guys are paired.
You don't. I mean, you can go on your own. I went with a good friend of mine from work, but also a friend that I've known since high school, and I also got to do it with the oldest, our fourth member of the Brothers Bear podcast, Mr. Cesar Medrano.
The eldest brother.
And him and also my sister-in-law.
Which he's coming, by the way. He's on his way right now. Yeah, he's on just his grabbing way. Some pizza for
he's
us.
He's grabbing us pizza, as always. He's made it to every single show.
Mm-hmm. At the very end. Never catch you on the top. Oh, man.
I want to say, this right here was the monkey bar thing. And then I'm going to...
I was going to ask you what that is.
If you could kind of see right here, I like the nastiest battle wound from this. Now... Right here, you start off like there's these little rings.
Oh, I see the
rings. This one doesn't really show it. But the one I did, there was a ring and there was a rope that you had to pretty much swing across. And then you grab the bar that's in the middle, grab the bar, go across that, and then grab another rope.
That's some American Ninja shit right
yeah,
there,
yeah, honestly,
bro.
That was the closest thing to American Ninja Warrior that I got. I was like, oh, my Jesus. Oh, my I always Jesus. Wanted to do this.
I am so not ready.
DJ Slim, there should be, I want to say video one, if you can play that. If you can.
If you can, yes. Bear with us, folks.
Bear with us.
DJ Slim can only do so much.
So, there I am.
Is that you right there?
Yeah, that's me. And I was like, and then, bam!
Yeah! Fucking A, bro. It's good shit.
My girlfriend happened to be, she's the one that actually captured the video.
Did you almost die of exhaustion?
Honestly, that was only one because she was there. I was like, I don't want to fail this in front of her.
So, oh, yeah. You gave it all.
I was like,
big effort then.
And here's the before and after pictures. As you could tell, I started the race with a shirt. Came back with no shirt.
No shirt at all.
No
look
shirt.
Look at those muscles, though, bro. Oh, my God. That's so sexy. I'm trying to show this sexy arms of Carlos there. Uy. That's some buff shit right there, dude.
That's called training, man.
Training, dude. Got the Eye of the Tiger song going all the whole time there, right?
The next intro, I'm just going to open it up like that, dude.
So you got your homies there.
Yeah, I mean.
Shout outs. Oh, there's Caesar, yes.
Yeah. The oldest, fourth member. The eldest brother bear.
Who's coming with pizza right now. Bringing us.
He'll be here.
Pepperoni mushroom.
I do want to say this special kind of mushroom.
Ooh,
I like that. I do want to say this about the brother, the Spartan race.
Mm-hmm.
I think the biggest thing that people kind of don't, the reason why they don't do it, honestly, it really, this race isn't just for people that are fit. Like, that's one of the biggest common things I always hear. Like, oh, I don't want to do it. We're being sexy in this photo. We got like, yeah, we finished.
I don't want to do it. I'm too fat.
Yeah. That's only, honestly, one of the biggest things I've ever heard. Like, I always hear, because I also.
That's what I'm telling myself right now.
You wouldn't do it?
Fuck no, I'm fat. I'm pondering. That's, you know, because I've been thinking of walking down, up mountains and shit, you know, like trail walking.
Yeah.
You know, and that's been in the thought process for like the last year or two. I haven't really got to it yet. You know, we got the equipment for it. Steady.
So
slow and steady.
If I asked you to go on a hike with me, you wouldn't go?
Nah, yeah, think about it really hard, bro. I'd be considered really, you know, for sure. And try to put it in my calendar, maybe. Don't pressure me, man.
No, I want to go on a hike with you.
Don't pressure me, man. Hey, yeah, I'll tell you right now. It was about a year ago. Shout out to my cousin Bobby if he's listening. I hit him up. I was like, hey, bro, I'm fucking fat. I need you to help me. Train me, bro. And he's like, all right, well, we got to do this. We got to do that. And what do you want to start? I'm like, ASAP, right? And he's like, all right, dude, we'll do tomorrow. I'm like, all right. And, you know, that was the last time we talked about it. shamefully enough, man. I am ashamed of it, though. This is, as funny as it is, folks, we need to fucking wake up as a country and get into fucking shape.
See, I got to thank my girlfriend on that, too. She's like, she pushes me to the limit. Right on, she worked at a 24-hour fitness for a while.
Oh, fuck. No wonder, dude. Let me get you, whip you up into shape.
I was just like, the week of the thing, I was training with her, my friend and I, and we were just like, ugh. Like, honestly, if you fail an obstacle course, like, they make you do burpees. And I don't know why I've never trained to actually do a proper burpee. I was like, maybe I could do this. And then there she is. Like, yeah, she trained us the week. My friend and I have been, like, literally training and working out prior way before this. But the week of, she was on her asses about it. And I kind of want to throw her at you to get you to do some stuff. I want to see you do like just one day of work, man.
Like, the world's biggest loser. No, in my end, it'd be the world's lamest fucking idiot trying to be a loser.
but going back on it though, like on mm-hmm. like on their Instagram, and then I've noticed too on their Facebook account. Or things like that. Like I know that sometimes, I don't know how it is, but the only images I've seen are fitted people. Mm-hmm. You know, like they look fucking buff and crazy. Yeah. I remember a while back when I signed up, and even after my friend had signed up, we joked about like, man, we're probably going to be the only out of shape ones on this course, you know? But honestly, when you're going through everything, you see people from all shapes and sizes, you know? Mm-hmm. It didn't really matter that if you're fitted or not. You really had to go in with just motivation and having the heart to complete something. And I think anyone can do it. Like, you can do it, dude. Mm-hmm. Like, your mind right now is telling you, like, I can't do it because you're saying you're fat or whatever, you know?
Yeah.
But if you go in with the heart of it, like, fuck it, I'm going to do this. Mm-hmm. That's what it takes, dude.
Oh, and your body definitely... I'm sorry to cut you off.
Mm-hmm. No.
Yeah, your body definitely needs it, though, too.
Yeah, right? it does help, but it's really, like... Almost kind of like in a ratatouille form where, like, you know, anyone can cook. Like, this mm-hmm. is, like, anyone can do it.
Yeah.
Just, like, literally the whole Nike logo, just do it kind of deal, you know? Mm-hmm. And I saw people on there that just weren't giving up. Like, you do see people that are sitting there like, I can't do this, you know? But you see some heavy set people that you're passing them, and then they're still going. They're like, I'm struggling going up a hill, and I see someone... at the top, and it's like, you made it, I can make it. Mm-hmm. You know, and that's what I really like seeing, that like everyone, and just random, you know. I even saw like an older lady that was up there, and she's like, and I didn't see it, but my girlfriend had told me that she saw somebody with crutches. Like, there towards the end, one of the last things you had to do was like a rope climb, and then you had to climb it up, smack a bell, and like mm-hmm. a bunch of people were just failing this thing, they couldn't do it. And this girl with these crutches, like, shows up, and she just does it like nothing.
Yeah, dude.
So it shows, like, you just have the heart and the motivation to do it, you know?
You would think she would have a lot of upper body strength, though, with the crutches walking around, right? She had a little advantage.
But it shows,
mostly, like, people walk, they don't really, you know.
Because I have had friends, I've tried, like, when I first signed up, I thought I was almost going to do this on my own, you mm-hmm. know? And I remember I was telling a couple of my friends, and then, yeah, the same reaction, it was just like, fuck that, I'm fat. Like, I can't do this. Like, I'm out of shape. I'm like, dude, just... It's not something you can do, like, train for a week. Like, you got to do, yeah, I mean, you do train for it, you know, but don't expect, like, just if you don't have abs. I mean, dude, I was walking around with a shirt, and I have a panza, and I'm still going. Like, I was still going. I mean, yeah, I got some arms, but, like, I still did it, you know?
Oh, I hate my panza and love it at the same time. Dude, show that shit off. Ooh, look at that.
Trying to not get that glare.
Ladies and gentlemen, that image that you guys see right there is the anguish and suffering that he endured, Carlos, but at the end came through successfully.
This is Sparta!
DJ Slim, if you can, find a video that has, like, you'll see, like, a bunch of people jumping in a mud and then kind of climbing up on a wall, like the mud wall.
Mud wall. with 2 minutes left, bro, let's see what you got. Let's see what you got.
That was probably one of my favorite moments, was the mud climb.
That they had there?
Yeah. Mm. Like, you just jump in a ditch of, like, just literally mud water, and then you had to climb over a wall. And that, at that moment, it didn't matter that you went in alone or you with your group of friends. Everybody was helping out each other. Mm. Like, there was this guy, I swear, my brother and I even said he was, like, MVP. All of us, like, it was a group of four. We were the ones that did it all together. But we were saying there was this guy in that part, the only reason why we remember him the most, because he had nipple piercings. And we're like, man, we kept saying, he's like, man, nipple piercings, had he was MVP. Mm-hmm. Like, we got there and he was like, all right, man, your turn, and he was like making sure we got over this wall. Like, he would, like, put his knee out, we'd step on it and then push, and then he was just like, don't lift up, don't stand up, just, like, put your knee, like, literally we're, like, digging our nails into the mud and then just crawling, and then people on top are, like, reaching out their arms, and it was like those movie moments where you barely, your fingertips just touch, and you're just like,
oh, yeah.
Just that.
Cliffhanger, like, shit, yeah, right? Like,
And then they would reach up and, like, yeah, reach out, grab you, and then you would pull up and you're pulling your next the next person. Mm-hmm. It got to a point where people were doing that for me, and I was like, you know, fuck this. Like, I'm going to do this for others, too.
Yeah.
So I'm like, because I'm tall, I'm, like, literally, like, leaning over as much as I can, and I'm reaching, and because of my, like, the length of how tall I am, I was just grabbing people, just throwing them over me,
yeah,
dude. Like, it was like, come on. And once I saw, like, there was, like, nobody for a while, then I would move to the next section. Like, we just kept going. I think there was three walls, and at the end, you had to go under like a wall into the mud.
All right, bro, we need to finish this up. All right, we're gonna folks, when we come back, we're gonna continue on with this, finish it up, man, because we need to bring in the whole successness of it. And also movie reviews coming up too. Cooties.
Oh no,
come back.
Don't you leave.
This is the Brothers Bear Podcast Live. We're gonna come back, so please come back. Yo.
Located in Monrovia, California, Mount Sierra College prepares highly skilled graduates for careers in management, information technology, media arts, and game arts. Transfer earned credits or start right after high school and earn a bachelor's degree in 4 years or less. Combine industry-driven, hands-on small classes with your general education units. Mount Sierra College. Invest in yourself. Financial aid is available for those who qualify.
It's hot out here. I need a drink.
Have a mucho macho michelada.
What's a michelada?
Michelada is a Mexican Bloody Mary made with beer. All you have to do is get bucket-sized michelada, open it up, pour it in your favorite beer, and you're good.
What if you don't like beer?
You can use it in lemon-lime soda, vodka with lime, or tequila with lemon-lime soda.
Sounds delicious.
Where do you find it? You can find it at your favorite store, or you can go to muchomachomichelada.com.
Find us on Twitter and Facebook.
That needs to get noticed, your ideas need a great website. And at Infuse, we build simple, clean, and efficient websites. We believe that even the wildest ideas should come to life in a beautiful way. We build responsive sites, e-commerce sites, and even help with business email setup and search engine optimization. Every great idea needs a great website. Start your new look today. Check us out at www.infuse.com. That's www.enfuse.com. Or call us at 800-542-4783. Again, that's 800-542-4783. Infuse, we get it done.
A home is the biggest investment in most people's lives. Buying or selling should be a positive experience.
Whether you want to be a wealthy real estate investor or just trying to find a place to call home, at AJR & Associates, we focus on the client's needs.
We understand the market better than most. Let us bring the value to you and make the right choice.
AJR & Associates, making your dream house a reality. Call us today for a free consultation at 562-882-1976. Or you can log on to www.hgrrealtors.com.
With a track record of great results, bringing knowledge, wisdom, and expertise to you. Hablamos Español.
ProTech Carpet, Tile, and Care provides professional cleaning services for carpet, tile, grout, upholstery, and fine area rugs.
ProTech technicians are professionally trained and certified cleaning and restoration experts.
We specialize in restoring damage caused by heavy soil and odor.
We can remove challenging spots such as coffee, tea, ink, gum, wine, and many more.
We have saved our customers thousands of dollars on new flooring and furniture expenses with our advanced cleaning processes.
Call for a free estimate at 562-447-4300 and visit us on our website, www.myprotechsite.com.
Hey, this is Joe Perez, owner at ProTech. Just reminding you that ProTech Carpet and Tile Care is your professional choice.
Do we have your attention? When it comes to tequila, two things matter. Heart and passion. Never compromising integrity for mass production. Number one tequila delivers the goods. Taste the heart and passion of Mexico in every bottle. We make it right. We make it fun. Superior tequila. There's only number one. There's only number one. There's only number one.
Looking for a delicious, fresh family meal that's ready when you are and easy on your budget?
Welcome to Piara Pizza. We make our pizzas with handmade dough, 100% real cheese, and tomato sauce blended with our own spices. Nothing is ever frozen. We always have large pepperoni and cheese pizzas fresh and waiting for you for only $5. Or choose one of our specialty pizzas. We have veggie, meat lovers, supreme, and Hawaiian. Add an order of our amazing hot wings, cheesy bread, or breadsticks. Our locations are ultra-modern, ultra-clean, and open 7 days a week. Visit any one of our locations today. Or check us out on the web at www.piarapizza.com. Piara Pizza. Fresh, hot, and ready for you when you come in. Stop in for your Piara Pizza today.
We are the Three Guys Rant with Arvin, Mike, and Phil.
Make sure to check us out every week at thethreeguysrant.com.
And you'll find out what they say we're faces for radio and voices for the deaf. Damn right. Have you seen your stuff lately?
Hey, I'm audio candy.
All right. Always tune in each week so you can hear the really absurd news and talk with the Three Guys Rant. Arvin, how do they reach us?
Call us at 855-69-3-GUYS. 855-69-3-GUYS.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to the Brothers Bear Podcast live on the Rant Radio Network. Don't go anywhere, kiddies. You wouldn't want to make the Joker sad, would you?
So I tells the guy, I'm not much of a politician, you know, but if Donald Trump doesn't win next year's election, or this year's election, I'm moving to Mexico, fuck it. Oh, I'll call you back, bro. Hey, welcome back to the Brothers Bear Podcast, special edition. The Sanchelus, man.
The Sanchelus.
Just saying it sounds so awful.
It does.
It's like a hole right now.
It also feels
like it needs to be filling.
It does. Shout out again to my brother for not being here. Moment of silence. Actually, he's fighting crime with food at the moment.
Yeah. bursting out with his professional taste buds,
He's giving out his man versus food critique style. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you've ever heard him do that. When he critiques food?
No, I actually haven't.
That's pretty amazing.
Is it really?
I'm not going to lie. He can improv when it comes to food, like taking a bite of something and be like, you know what? There's a little hint of a spice, but when you, learned how to do that because of him, but also actually watching Adam Richman do it. Mm-hmm. So I was like, oh, like that's how he did it. That's pretty funny how he does it.
I'm sure he gets it from TV though, right?
No, yeah. He technically got, that's how his impression is from a show, which I should have got it from that show, but I learned it more from watching him do it and how you just put certain stupid words together and it works well.
Oh, and I hope it works well for Sanj.
Yeah, he's right now doing an event for Mount Sierra College, or one of our sponsors. Time, you know, bringing it back, and he's tasting food. I don't know if he's doing anything else other than eating,
and free.
Free
sounds awesome.
It is.
Well, we couldn't be. He was there as part of the Brothers Bear podcast. expanding our logo, our grip.
Grip
on the city, then on the state, then on this country, and then on this world. The takeover. Are you ready?
Yeah.
All right. Hey, let's get back a little bit to the Spartan race, because man, you were getting all crazy, dude, with inspirational shit.
Yeah,
and I need that right now, because obviously, you know, I look the way I do, the age that I am. It's totally unnecessary. I've done it for way too long. It's fucking totally immature, and don't need that shit. You know, the worst thing I could do to my life right now is totally just fuck my body up, and it's easy to do with Fast Food Nation. You know, you got all these places that you can go to right away.
Especially living in La Puente, Hacienda, every single one of them right there.
You got the GMO grip, you know, mm-hmm. They're putting shit on our shit, and you know,
Bruce Jenner happens. And and you know, we need more inspiration. We need more of these stories, and I want to listen to more of it. So, sir,
a big thing too, honestly, going back into that photo that you keep zooming in all the way.
Oh shit.
No, is it up there? Oh, anyways. Yeah, I had a lot of motivation, a lot of people there supporting me for it, and as we mentioned on my birthday episode and prior to this, and why some episodes I was missing due to my writer's block. It was very emotional to cross that finish line. Mm-hmm. You know, especially the year of what I struggled with for myself. Mm-hmm. You know,
and fucking rewarding.
Yeah,
bit,
it was,
man.
Dude. It was. I honestly, like, I'm pretty sure that's one of the moments I wanted to break down, just knowing what I've been through. Mm-hmm. And why, you know, I think that's one thing when you're doing this race, everybody has a story. Everybody has a story, whether it's, you know, depression, you know, your weight, your, you know, there's people that, if you watch, look at the Instagram for the Spartan race, there's people that are doing it, like, that have, you know, no legs or no arms, or mm-hmm. they're just, but they're still doing it. Like, if it's motivation for anybody, everybody has their backstory of why they're, you know, why they're doing it. But at the end of the day, everybody's one because you're doing it all together. And that's why I think that the mud climb was my favorite part. Mm-hmm. Like other parts, you know, like other obstacles were fun because, you know, you're helping out each other to jump over a wall, you know, you're boosting someone up over, you know, but the mud wall was, yeah, hands down for me, my favorite part. Cause that was the one where, during the wall, I would help, you know, I had helped my friend or help somebody else. But to see everybody right there stuck at that moment, because not only that, you're standing in mud and you're sinking in. Like, it's water, but then you're also, shit, like, fucking sinking in. So you're trying to, your weight of your shoes now having mud, and then the water, it's just, it's so much, and you're just trying to climb up. Yeah, the second wall we went up, I remember I was just, like, literally climbing, and I was just, like, sliding, but then somebody else pushed me up, and then that's what got me to keep going. And after that, I was like, all right, someone helped me, I'm going to help them. It was just, boom. Let's get this next person, you know? And even because at that moment, I didn't have a shirt on already. That's where I lost my shirt. I had like handprints on my back because when you're trying to go over, you're just grabbing anything you can, you know? You don't want to slide down. Like you're mm-hmm. grabbing someone's arm and they're like throwing you over. But at that moment, you're grabbing the next thing you can see that you just, well, not see, but you just can get a hold of and then to pull yourself over, you know? I would love to do that part over again. And I can't wait because with the Spartan race, there's called the trifecta, which, yeah, you do. Right here is the first piece, as you can see.
Okay, let me try to shut off.
So not only do you get your medal, your little medallion-looking medal. Other one. Oh.
This one?
Yeah. So since, like I said earlier, there's three of them. There's the sprint, which is the first one, then there's your super, and then the last one is the beast.
Oh, and this shit just says that you finished it too, so you're not even lying. I can't claim you lying, bro.
Thanks.
You did it.
And on top of that, you can connect all three, and they make the full circle.
Oh, that's fucking dope, dude.
So that's what I'm planning to do now, is to complete that full circle.
This Spartan mask reminds me of Danger Mouse. Or MF Doom. It's heavy as a motherfucker, too. So that's very inspirational, bro. You make me want to change my life.
Do it with me.
I will.
No, I'm being serious,
too. No, I'm serious, too. I know. It fucking sounds like I'm lying. And I apologize to everybody that knows me. Everything that comes out of my mouth is seriously sincere.
If you're free, even if I'm fucking around, let's do this together.
No, yes, and you know what? I say we incorporate it to the Brothers Bear show, and we'll do progress reports. You know, we'll get crazy with it. You know, mm-hmm. and we'll get people involved, and they're gonna be like, "Oh my God, we gotta run too! We gotta run for our lives!" For our lives, folks.
Well, Iron Maiden plays in the background.
Run to the hills. Run fire. Life. That was beautiful.
It was, actually.
So, wait, the image is not there anymore. It's all good. When you were there and you were in that moment, mm. what song would you imagine to be there? You know, like
I knew you were gonna fucking ask me this question.
You know me too well.
Bro. The irony was at one moment, there's a part because one of the obstacles was we had to go up this steep hill. Like, and we had to carry these heavy ass sandbags on us.
Mm-hmm. Fuck, dude, they don't mess around, dude.
Now, I don't know why, but a song from Mulan was stuck in my head.
From what?
From Mulan, Disney's Mulan.
What the fuck?
It's that song Be a Man or whatever. And the song was playing in my head. Earlier, we were listening to that song from The Karate Kid before we got there. It's the, you're the best.
So I can be, yeah, you know, like it was motivation.
Yeah. Like, yeah, I the tiger. But I don't know why during the race, Mulan was playing in my head. I was like, be a man. But, like, I don't know why.
Yeah, it's a good song.
It is. Honestly,
it picks you up and it makes you want to go forward.
There was a moment where we're now going downhill. It was quiet. It was just like you could kind of hear like breathing. Like my friend and I weren't talking to each other. We were just kind of like focusing, like just making sure like we don't step and, you know. And then it's just quiet and just muffled, like and just hear music. Like it was a moment where everyone just kind of stopped and turned around, like what the fuck is going on? Yeah. And then all you hear is, back that ass up. But that one song was, somebody had one of those like Bluetooth.
Damn, his head is. Oh man, what is his name? Keep going with the song.
I don't know, something back that ass up.
You was a fine motherfucker when you back that ass up.
It was just playing.
Call me Big Daddy when you back that ass up. Girl, is he playing when you back? Juva motherfucking Nile. Oh, Juvenile in the house.
And the guy passed all of us.
Everybody?
He was just like, he's all into it. But I was like, man, on the next race, he's I'm like, going to do that.
Back that ass up.
There was one of my, you know me, I love to make people laugh. That's one of my biggest things. Mm-hmm. And I had a moment during the race where I had everybody laughing. And it was one of those moments where you're kind of hating life, but something makes you laugh that you're just like, you can't help but laugh, you know? And there, we had to do a barbed wire, like we were crawling, but if you lifted up, barbed wire was right behind your back. Like if you went two up, that was it. Like you were going to scratch your back up with barbed wire.
Mm-hmm.
And I know like people were just kind of crawling. Luckily, like one of my things that my friend and I were training too was that we were doing minute planks during our workout session. And the crawling wasn't that bad. Like it was just, you know? But then other people were just saying, like, if you roll, it makes it easier. So we were just kind of rolling to get it, just to get it done with. So you kind of go up and then you kind of go down, like a little hill. Yeah. You know? And I was like, I didn't want to crawl anymore. So I just started rolling to get it done with.
Uh-huh.
And I'm rolling down. And in my mind is like, man, this is the only type of rolling where I'm going to do it as a straight edge, like just straight edge rolling. But as I'm rolling, the second song to pop up in my head, I was like, they see me rolling. They hate. And I'm just doing that.
They hate.
Everybody that heard me was just laughing. They're like, everyone's just like, fuck, I don't want to do this. And then all you hear is me rolling down the hill. Like, they see me rolling. Everybody's laughing. It's like, yes, I fucking got people to laugh at that, dude. So at that moment, like that motivation, like who cares? Just have a good time. Yeah. Laugh. You don't fucking laugh. Yeah. We're all in the heat. We're all crawling, but just fucking have a good time, you know? And that's at that moment, I made everybody forget that they're crawling because they were just laughing while crawling, you know? It was fun. Honestly, I can't wait for the next one. You know, now you're going to do it.
Oh, yeah. I imagine the footage that you guys can get off of me struggling. Oh, which is a question that I wanted to ask.
Caesar actually had a GoPro on him, so there's footage
on that. Oh, that's dope.
So I got little footage. You know,
I got a GoPro, bro.
But my brother has a GoPro, so he was recording, so pretty soon we'll get a video of that. It's him. Like, I come out here and there. I think, one of my proudest moments, too, that I got to share with my brother. Like, my brother and I have gone places here and there. My brother's been in the military, so we really haven't had bonding moments, and this is the first time where we actually got to bond, you know. Him being in the military, this is the closest thing that I can say military wise
style, yeah, you
know? Like doing his course and on his GoPro, there's a moment that you get to see him and I like work together. You know, that's what I really liked. I got to share that moment with my brother. And a big shout out to him as well, you know, for serving what he did, you know, being in the military, doing his tours in Afghan and Iraq, And then, you know, being now here with us, and I got to do this with my brother.
Getting us some pizza, too, man. I can't wait. I'm still, I mean, every time I think about it, I get really hungry now.
Oh, dude, we had, I was, like, staying away from burgers for a while. I would break edge and eat a burger here and there. Mm. But after this, I was just, like, I was so hungry. Like, I was just, like, eat so bad. You know?
Cheat or what?
Yeah, that's what they call it. Cheating. For anyone that is interested, the next sprint here will be in December, I think 5th and 6th is the next one right there in Temecula. And then the Spartan Race Super is going to be next year, January 27th, and then I think 26th and 27th.
Right on.
So,
well, one more question. How long does it, I mean, you can go as in your leisure, right?
Yeah, I mean.
It starts, and then you can just, you pace yourself or whatever.
There's really no time limit.
So what time do they stop it? Like they're always gonna be like very kind to you and say, oh no, there's no time limit, but you know, there is one.
I don't know if
How long is the deadline? Like, how long do I have to? How long would it take? You know, can I? How slow can I go? Is what I'm saying.
You can go pretty slow. I mean,
it's a whole day thing. Like 24 hours later, I'm still in the course.
It's like, Edgar, you haven't even left the starting line.
I'm not ready, bro. Like, after 8 hours, you're just going to be like, you know what, man? Come on, bro. Fucking walk or something. Instead of whining and shit. Sliding down head first.
I'm just, bro, I'm like dragging you by your foot. Come on.
All right. We told you we were going to bring you a movie review, and that's what we're going to do. Bring you a movie review. For you, movie review. For you, movie review.
All right.
See, there's your piece right there, bro. Exclusive Brothers Bear collab. Nice little thing we did for you guys.
Before we recorded earlier today, Shweddy and myself recorded this new Brothers Bear.
Listen to my voice, man. Just JB, we ain't got shit on
that. I'm doing the piano work.
Big shout outs to Music Box. Is that what it's called? I forgot what it's called now. Oh no, Hip Hop Box app.
Oh no, wonder I couldn't find the app.
I thought I told you the wrong one.
Alright, so this past week I saw a movie called Cooties.
Cooties?
Cooties is a American independent horror comedy. So not only is it a horror film, it's a comedy film.
Ooh.
To prep you up.
That's a kooky combination.
It is. To prep you up right before we even get to October, where you should just be watching horror films left and right, why not start a little stuff and go with a horror comedy?
Yeah.
Enjoyable. So you're not
start
too
you up early.
You know, you're not too scared, but at the same time, you're having fun. Mm-hmm. And actually, this is what Cooties does to you. It's a fun horror comedy flick. And the last time, I haven't seen something this well done since Dale and Tucker. And
Tucker and Dale's
versus...
I
don't remember the name of the movie.
Let me look it up here. Tucker, I know which one you're talking about.
What I liked about this film, it's one of those zombie, you know, one of the biggest things about zombie films is that, what started the plague? This one actually gives you it right in the, no spoiler.
So zombies.
Yeah, it's like a zombie. It's
Tucker
a different,
and Dale versus Evil, sorry.
It's a different take on zombies. But this time it's with children.
Children, yeah.
And that's what I like about it is that you got to see adults kick little kids' asses, basically, you know?
Which is every adult that doesn't have kids' dream. And some that do, I guess. Not me, just sometimes.
The cast is really well put together. I think Rainn Wilson was my favorite character. Mm-hmm. He's you know, it follows your standard points of, you know, who's this person, who's that. But Rainn Wilson's character just makes you love him and hate him at the same time. So he does, he played that part, you know, well. Elijah Wood is the main lead in this one, and he's apparently he's a writer. So like little moments right there, he's like, I'm trying to write a book. Oh, I got an idea. And then even though things are happening in the background, he's just like, what the hell are you doing? He's like, it's for my book. It's for my book. You know?
That's like a running gag in the movie.
And it happens a couple of times in there.
What is he, like a substitute teacher or something?
Yeah, he's a substitute teacher.
Okay, and an inspiring writer.
Pretty much. Like that's how he ends up at that school, and then all hell breaks loose the day he gets there.
Every time Elijah Wood's on something, I'm interested. I like that guy. I like how
I like this character. You know,
he looks dope.
You know, there's moments where you're like, man, Elijah Wood, he's pretty good.
He's pretty good. I like that. Hey, he should win an Oscar before Leonardo DiCaprio.
Jack McBriar, from also, you know him well from 30 Rock.
Mm-hmm.
And then also the couple from Forgetting Sarah Marshall.
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah.
He's like, God put our heads on our mouths for a reason. his character, like, honestly, everybody.
He looks a lot like Rainn Wilson. I always get those two guys confused.
Jack McBriar, or who?
Yeah.
Jack McBriar and Rainn Wilson?
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Maybe not. I'm thinking of the song. Continue. I'm sorry.
Like I said, it's a fun ride. I like the take on zombies because it's. They're infected, and then it really is cooties at some point. Like, of course.
Yeah.
At certain one point where they had to get something, this is probably the only time I'm going to spoil something. Elijah Wood has to go through the air. Like, they all get away from all the kids.
Yeah, I seen that.
And then they're like in the, I want to say a boiler room, and Elijah Wood has to go through the air vents to get something.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the little girls that they saved before, like, anything happened to her, she does, like, the traditional circle, circle, dot, dot, now you got your cootie shot. And I was just like, oh, that's adorable. That little girl. Whew, you can do that to me. Now, you know?
Like, save me.
They have that cool little montage of everybody prepping up to, you know, with their battle scene.
Yes, for that, the zombies. You know,
that was really cool. The only thing I will say about the movie that I did not like is the ending. And not that it's a bad ending. It just, the way it ends is so sudden that it leaves you really like, what the? You want more.
Mm-hmm.
That's only, my only issue is like the way it's done.
Abruptly, yeah.
And I was like, what the? Like, really? That's how they're going to end? Like, I thought it was going to, I could have gone probably with another 20 minutes and I would have been good with it, you know? But that was, yeah, that's honestly my only issue with the film.
I feel like I've heard that a lot. When it comes to zombie movies, is people's dissatisfaction with the endings.
Yeah.
Like, it's a common thing.
Well, this one, I mean, there's some pretty good zombie films where the ending's like, all right, you kind of know. Or it's almost a cliche where they all either die or, like, the two, like, it's that big-ass group mm-hmm. and then everybody dies but two, you know?
Yeah.
Like, Shaun of the Dead, everybody practically dies. Spoiler. Everybody practically dies except for Shaun and was it Lily? Or, no, I forgot her name. Mm-hmm. But, and then they get saved last minute, you know?
Yeah.
You see Ed get taken out and get bitten up, but you do kind of see him at the end as a zombie. But this one, you're right. There are a lot of zombie films there.
or horror films.
Yeah.
One that reminds me is Cabin in the Woods. Even though I actually like the ending, I hear a lot of people not being too happy with it.
Yeah, I have a love-hate with that movie.
Yeah, I know you do.
My brother can praise that one up and down, but I'm like...
But we're essentialist today, so we will go past that.
Wait, what?
So, this movie must be watched.
Yeah, it's fun, dude. I was laughing hard, too. Mm-hmm. The moments, like, the laughs are there when they need to be, and the scares are there when they need to be as well. Like, everything was well done. It was well written. Just for me, the ending was like, it felt a little flat.
What was the scariest moment for you?
There's a moment where they're, like, you think that's it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they're just stuck in the middle, and they end up like in a Chuck E. Cheese kind of place,
mm-hmm.
and they're like in a circle, and then they're all right there, like in the little playpen, like they're all like surrounding them, and at that moment, like I really like to put myself in the shoes of the characters, so I'm putting myself in that position of like, what the hell's gonna happen if I was put there?
Mm.
You know, and it's just like, oh shit, like. You know, I always think of myself and how much my brother has a fear of zombies.
Mm-hmm.
I could just imagine him being there.
Mm-hmm.
So he'd be like, you know.
Yeah. I've seen videos of people making this big old elaborate thing to make it seem like there's going to be a zombie apocalypse. And they put someone in there that's unknown of the situation.
Mm-hmm.
and the way they freak out, it's usually funny.
It is.
But imagine putting yourself in that position. That's fucking, you can get a heart attack and shit, dude.
I like how people, I mean, when they think that, oh man, if the zombie apocalypse happens, I got this. Like, no, you don't.
Yeah, right. Yeah, you know, like,
put yourself in that real situation.
You're gonna cry like a little bitch.
There's always a, I'll get a gun. Or just, like, where are you gonna get the gun?
Yeah.
Well, I'm gonna. No, you're not gonna. Yeah. No.
Even if you put, if there's stuff there for you, I mean, you'll still freak out.
Before we go, like, actually, out of my four stars or my four thumbs up, I don't remember what I give out. I forget. But I want to go just three, a solid three on this one.
Solid three. Yeah. That's enough for me. That's what I meant to say. That three is enough for me to watch. And if you guys are dedicated Brothers Bear podcast listeners, you gotta fucking check it out, right?
Mm-hmm. Do that.
Because if you don't, then you fucking just wasting your life right now and uninteresting things.
Yeah, thanks to me, DJ Slim has seen a handful of movies and really liked.
Yeah, and what do you say, DJ Slim, to that? No, he gives a big thumbs up. Big thumbs up from DJ Slim. It looked a little sarcastic, but, you know, it's maybe the glare.
That was sarcastic.
You just flip me the bird. All right, folks, we come back. It's the closer and the songs of the week and other fun stuff. So please come back.
You come back, goddammit!
Been in an accident? Then you need your vehicle professionally repaired. That's exactly what you get when you bring your vehicle to Greg's Auto Body Repair. Three quotes within minutes. We will provide everything you need for a hassle-free auto body repair, from an accurate estimate to working with your insurance company. We will get your vehicle to its pre-accident condition as soon as possible. Greg's Auto Body has been serving Los Angeles County and local cities since 1970. Call us at 562-789-1300.
The experts know that for pastry, Baker's Bodega has it all. Exclusive brands like Westco Bankmark, Satin Ice, and Pastry Pride. One-on-one day seminars for cake decorating and gelatin art. So for our service, wide range of ingredients and supplies, and for the low prices, Baker's Bodega has it all. But you don't need to be an expert. Baker's Bodega, 7869 Paramount Boulevard in Pico Rivera. Come, we're waiting for you.
Located in Monrovia, California, Mount Sierra College prepares highly skilled graduates for careers in management, information technology, media arts, and game arts. Transfer earned credits or start right after high school and earn a bachelor's degree in 4 years or less. Combine industry-driven, hands-on small classes with your general education units. Mount Sierra College. Invest in yourself. Financial aid is available for those who qualify.
A home is the biggest investment in most people's lives. Buying or selling should be a positive experience.
Whether you want to be a wealthy real estate investor or just trying to find a place to call home, at AJR & Associates, we focus on the client's needs.
We understand the market better than most. Let us bring the value to you and make the right choice.
AJR & Associates, making your dream house a reality. Call us today for a free consultation at 562-882-1976. Or you can log on to www.hgrrealtors.com.
With a track record of great results, bringing knowledge, wisdom, and expertise to you. Hablamos Español.
Do we have your attention? When it comes to tequila, two things matter. Heart and passion. Never compromising integrity for mass production. Number one, tequila delivers the goods. Taste the heart and passion of Mexico in every bottle. We make it right. We make it fun. Superior tequila. There's only number one. There's only number one. There's only number one.
Business that needs to get noticed? Your ideas need a great website. And at Infuse, we build simple, clean, and efficient websites. We believe that even the wildest ideas should come to life in a beautiful way. We build responsive sites, e-commerce sites, and even help with business email setup and search engine optimization. Every great idea needs a great website. Start your new look today. Check us out at www.enfuse.com. That's www.enfuse.com. Or call us at 800-542-4783. Again, that's 800-542-4783. Enfuse, we get it done.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to the Brothers Bear Podcast live on the Rant Radio Network. Don't go anywhere, kiddies. You wouldn't want to make the Joker sad, would you?
To the top off, you will be drinking their nobodies, and we'll be kissing. I just wanna have fun tonight. Put me under the flashing light. Let me blow out this house tonight. Wake up, freaky yippie! La 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 la! Wake up, hollow, wake up, hollow! We can do this on hollow! Wake up, freaky if you want!
Bitch, I'm a bomber!
Wake up, hollow, wake up, hollow! We can do this on hollow! Wake up, freaky if you want! Wake up, hollow, wake up, hollow! We can do this on hollow! Wake up, freaky if you want!
Bitch, I'm a bomber!
Bitch, I'm a bomber!
Bitch, I'm a bomber!
Bitch, you're my dummy.
Bitch, I'm a donna.
Bitch, I'm a donna.
Bitch, I'm a donna.
Dang it. I'm froze up with my stove up because it's eating like Christina.
Whoa.
Who's the king to you? Ha, 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 be off now.
Hey guys, thank you for tuning in to the Brothers Bear Podcast.
We had to give that to you.
Yeah, we did.
We had to.
You showed me that video earlier, and I, whew, the timing was great when you showed me. A big shout out to the man, our number one fan, since the beginning. I thought you were going to say it.
Wait, the Dieter?
Yes.
Oh, the Dieter. Deet, 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 deet. He just heard the last segment and he wants to run with us. It was a cheap ass song.
No, no song is cheap when it comes from us. And a big shout out to Sarah, a good friend of mine, who also did the Spartan race. Also proud of her as well.
So, Dieter just challenged me because he heard our little segue. I was hoping he didn't, but you know, let's move forward.
He listens, man.
He challenged me to do the challenge, and I accepted, unwillingly, of course. But you know, you gotta do what you gotta do, and I gotta man up. It's for my kids. This is for my kids. This is for my wife. This is for all the fans out there. This
and
is for you, Dieter. This it's for my dog Sunshine, a Welsh Corgi from England, Welshire. Imported, very expensive dog. That's why I love her so much.
I love her too.
And let's do it, man. Let's do it, Brothers Bear style. Oh man, scary shit though, man. I don't. I'm not excited.
I got
whatsoever.
This, man. I got you. Got you. It? I got you.
You got me?
I got you.
All right, we'll see how you got me, bro. All right, let's get into the song of the week. Song of the Week is here. Another nice little clip from the Brothers Bear duo of Carlos and I doing crazy shit on the little stuffies for music enjoyment.
Le Schwetz here was on the ones and twos with the beats.
I banged that shit hard, right? Ooh, what you know about that little...
We're on those beats. He made a drop.
Like it's
and
hot.
I was on keys. I was on keys. The little piano riff there was on me.
It was beautiful, man. It was beautiful. Oh, it took us like 2 seconds to do. So fuck you guys.
Actually, we're going to be going on tour soon.
The whole crew. We're going to do the whole world tour. We're going to hit up Japan first because they love the underground, bro. Shit, before we even fucking came out with the idea.
They already knew.
They already bought the tickets. They're like, fuck, we want in. So, yes. Nice little ditty we made for this week's Song of the Week.
We're opening up for DJ Slim.
DJ Slim.
What'd you think of that, DJ?
All right, he gave us a pro. He didn't know either.
Yeah, it still looked a little sarcastic to me, but I'm just going ahead and pass right through that. DJ Slim. So this week's Song of the Week picture, what do you see, man? What do you see? Do you see something? What is it that you see?
I see a guitar.
A guitar. What is... Okay, you see a bunch of junk, right?
Yeah,
a bunch of junk. Yeah. What is this junk? Like a guitar, an amp,
vinyl, tape.
Microphones. What is that?
Is this like one of those things, not like the other kind of pictures?
The wobble pedal.
There's a Marshall amp right there.
The acoustic guitar over there, a ukulele.
Am I supposed to see an image?
Like, do you not see an image?
I don't see an image.
All right, bro. Let me school you here, man.
Okay, please.
For all the kids who don't know, who don't understand this collage.
What is this collage?
This imagery of legendariness.
What's a legend?
Oh, it's a legend, yes. A legend in my eyes.
A legend? Like a legend that's like broke his guitar at a famous festival and then lit it on fire legend?
Oh, or? Yes, exactly. Yes, that's exact legend. Who didn't sing the Star Spangled Banner, but licked it.
I see what you did there. That was a good one, actually.
Yeah, yeah. This guy was so famous that Bob Dylan decided to to do his own song, the way that this guy did, which is Mr. Jimi Hendrix. Do you see now?
Oh yeah.
Do you see his face now?
Actually, in the words of Bob Dylan.
Yes, I do.
Yes, indeed.
I think about the Hendrix. I'm gonna sing the week and be sweaty.
I love Bobby D. I love Bobby D. impersonations too. Yeah. Always get me. I got a special heart for Bobby D.
Do you approve of my impression of him?
Yeah, I approve. Totally approve.
Thank you.
That was approved. And look how many, how Bob Dylan approves this nice little ditty there. Totally approves. That's how many.
I mean, if you got a cup like of coffee on you, you just.
Thank you.
Hey.
Just got a room with punches.
So, hey, I brought some stuff so I can share.
Oh, you do?
What's that little thing that they do for kids when you go to school and they're like, bring something and can talk about it?
Sharing time, I guess.
Isn't it share? Is it show and tell?
Oh, there we go. I brought my hamster once for show and tell.
That's pretty cute. I don't think I brought anything. Yeah, it was so damn poor.
I think it was either fifth or fourth grade.
Yeah, I
brought my hamster, and his name was Harvey. Harvey the hamster. And I remember during lunch, for our like little burgers, like the little salads, I had everybody collect their salad just to give it to my hamster.
That was pretty dope.
How much effort we all put in just to bring lettuce back to my hamster? Then good times.
All right, show and tell time, bro. Here, show the crowd. Guys, got a nice little scrapbook, Bob Dylan, scrapbook.
Yeah, scrapbook in 1956 to 1966. Scrapbook.
So I'm a big fan of this guy, as the well-known Brothers Bear fans know. I talk about this guy quite often.
Look at the photos.
Look at the pictures.
Pictures.
Scrapbook.
And content. Really?
Bunch of writings. Put it in a book. Sell that shit.
Is there a specific image you want me to show?
No, you can just pull it around. The reason why I brought this to share is so I can, nice little segue here, bro. That's what I'm trying to do is the segues. is I just found out the other day that Bob Dylan and Columbia Records is coming out yet again with another bootleg series.
Ooh. Oh my God!
Bootleg series, volume 12, The Cutting Edge. His shit from 1965 to 1966. If you are well-diversed into the Bob Dylan-ness, you would come up with the conclusion that this would include sessions from Bring It All Back Home, also from Highway 61 Revisited, and Blonde on Blonde as well. One of his most highly critical, most famous fucking shit that he's come, that he's shit out for us to smell.
You will
smell it.
Turns the tension.
6 discs.
My tongue was in Watchmen.
6 motherfucking discs. And let me just spill some ones out there.
Oh, okay. Please.
Piano stop. Demo version. I'll keep it in mind. Oh my God, I can't wait. Subterranean Homesick Blues, take 1, alternate take. Ooh. Oh, take motherfucking 1? I'll take 2.
Wait, speaking of takes, how many takes did we take today?
1.
1.
Only 1. One and only.
The one and only.
Ayo. What else you got? Mr. Tambourine Band with the band, take 3. Incomplete. Ooh. Oof, like a Rolling Stone short version, take 11. Take 5, rehearsal. Oh my God, he's gonna be like, let's do it like this, and then they do it, and I'm like,
doing these things.
And I'm all in it.
They
got right here sitting on a barbed wire fence. Now this, folks, was from the bootleg series. The first ones that came out, 1, 2, and 3, they had this song called Sitting on a Barbed Wire Fence, and it's fucking gangster, bro. And he fucking lays it and he licks it all over the fucking place. And I'm just sitting there on the barbed wire fence, just enjoying every single piece of it. And they got take 2 on this one. So I'm hoping that'd be a different take. Maybe he does something, you know, like a little different lick, you know, more of a slobber or less of a slobber than the dry licks that he comes out with. I don't know what I'm coming up with, what I'm saying. Anyways, well, what other ones that get my eye? Tell Leopard Skin Pillbox Hat, take 8, alternate take. All these alternate takes that I see are just, I'm going to fucking eat all this shit up, man. I can't fucking wait. I cannot wait. No, I'm so excited.
Can you hide it?
But that's not Song of the Week this week.
It's not.
It's not, bro.
No.
I'm sorry.
Our song wasn't even Song of the Week.
Our song wasn't Song. It was just an intro.
It was just an
introduction
intro
to the Song of the Week.
It was.
Which is this. No, I kid you. So, recently, like I told the folks here.
Oh, that's right. Apple.
I am going to use this new thing that I got called Apple Music that I subscribed to iPhone here.
You talked about it a couple of weeks ago.
Yes, and I said from now on, I'm going to use my Song of the Week picks with this
I
contraption.
That.
Right on. But I came up with a little setback, if you will, a pause.
Oh, what happened?
I'm frozen right now. And I'm gonna put this into a fuck you moment. We are Sanchless today, and we can't be Sanchless all the time. So, Sanch, I bring you your fuck you. This week's fuck you moment goes to Apple. As you can see, the lovely sacred apple that has been bitten into,
mm-hmm,
because we want to know. We want it all. Great hogging it.
Yes.
Mr. God. So Apple came up and they're like, all right.
Mm-hmm.
We got an upgrade, right? This is my story here. My fuck you moment story for Apple. I have this iPhone 5C here. Can you see it? Do you see?
Yeah, I do.
It's pretty cute, right?
Yeah.
It's not that old, right? It's like a year and a half. People telling me like, hey, it's time to upgrade. But it's only been a year and a half, you know? This thing's pretty expensive.
Well, it's because people like to just upgrade left and right.
nonetheless, all right? Sidetracking here. I, like any normal Apple holder, got an update recently, and I was like, oh, it's time to update. Hey, upgrades. Get them upgrades. And it's, we got the new stuff. You know, so I want it. So I plugged in my phone, and I'm like, upgrade. Or update. I'm sorry. It's the wrong word. Update. So, you know, went with, along the process, it updated, and then, like, about 15, 20 minutes later, I noticed that I lost my signal. I have no service. The service provider that I use confidently recently, not so much now, and I'm going to throw you out there, Verizon Wireless, got this phone from them. And so I did the update. It gave me no service. So I was like, hey, what the hey? You know, what's going on? 2 days later, say, you know, things continue to, mm-hmm. you know, no service. And I'm like, oh, that's very strange. So I go on online and, you know, I'm like, I'm savvy enough to fucking do this.
Yeah.
You know, myself, I don't need no help from anybody. Mm-hmm. So I did a system restore and rebooted the shit. I'm like, the natural thing to do is that right? So I did that successful first 5 minutes, right?
Yeah,
walking around like a fucking champ, like I did something, you know.
You're like, I did this. That was your own Spartan race.
Yeah, my own Spartan race. Yeah. And 5 minutes later, no service again. I'm like, oh dude, ooh, that's it's turning into a little problem there.
And because of this problem, it's been hard for you and I to contact each other.
Mm-hmm. It's been hard for me to listen to my fucking music, for another thing, you know.
Then you're the music guy.
And
so
I'm the music guy. Mm-hmm. So I have things to do, mm-hmm. you know, that I need that shit in other senses. The next thing I do is I go to Verizon store. I'm like, hey, so yeah, I've heard that there's issues. I read that, you know, that people have been going through this new update, and my phone. Can you help me out? He's like, oh, sure, maybe it's a SIM card, right? And so he does his thing, he fixes it, and it's like, oh, it's service, it's show service. And I'm like, oh, that's cool. And mm-hmm. he's like, yeah, and if that doesn't work out, you're going to have to go to Apple. And I'm like, oh, no, I don't want that. So, don't want to do that. So I was just happy, you know? I'm a happy guy, right? I'm walking out of the mall and shit, and like, I'm going to call my wife, right? I get my phone, I look at my phone, and there's no service. Like, ooh, this is getting really bad. I'm really not liking this anymore. Right? Because, you know, it's a phone.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And people need to fucking talk to me.
Yeah.
So,
I need
the service. So, I get on the internet and I'm all like, all right, you know, what's the next step? What's the next step, genius motherfucker? You know?
Yeah.
What do I do next? So I go on AppleStore.com, what have you, and then I try to find a guy to help me out, you know. The first place I go, I call is from Brea, you know. Yeah. Apple stores, as I'm sure the Apple holders know, there's not very much around Apple stores.
Yeah.
Right?
There's only two, and they both take forever to get to.
And they take forever to help you, too, because they don't give a fuck.
When I had to take my laptop in, it took me, I think, an hour and a half for mm-hmm. them to actually... Look,
like, say hi to you.
Yeah, just say hi to me. I went to my car, fell asleep, and then I came back.
Like, it's like the DMV, huh? Like, take a number. So, like, whatever. I call them. They're like, oh, you know, we don't accept
walk-ins.
No, not walk-ins. Fucking appointments. We can't do appointments. You have to walk in. And I'm like, all right. Well, how long does it take once I get there? It's like about an hour and a half. I'm like, for me to walk in. I don't get how I can't get an appointment. you know I'm coming. Why don't you just put me in as a walk-in right now and I'll meet you there? You know, and of course, he heard my tone and he got a little frisky and I was like, all right, goodbye now. I'll move on just as much as, you know, I'm sure you will.
You're unbelievable, man. You're unbelievable.
So I get back on Apple. I'm like, I got to call another store. I got to get this resolved, you know, because I have a life and I need a fucking phone. Who doesn't have a phone? Syria, refugees, you mm-hmm. know. I seen pictures of fucking Syrian refugees, you know, in camps with fucking cell phones, you know, surfing the fucking web. They, you know, they got it. I need it. You know, I mean, it can't be that fucking hard, right? Right? Anyway, so I call this other spot, and I'm like, all right, you know, there's a technician through the phone. He's like, oh, I'll help you out. And I'm like, all right. Fucking finally, yahoo. Success, 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 success.
A beam of light was dropping on you.
By the name of, by the name of Steve. So, here comes, man, my moment of you know,
your glory.
Glory, yes. Your, I will succeed.
Your Apple race?
Over the mountain.
Your Apple race?
Apple race, yes. I will meet Steve Jobs and say, congratulations. Good service.
In the heavens?
Yes. So the guy is like, okay, let me take you through the steps. And he's all like, oh, well, let me read some articles. Because, you know, though this case has happened to many other people, it's still very rare. You know? So he's like, have you tried the new upgrade to the upgrade? I mean, the update to the update. See, 2 weeks ago, there was an update, right? And now this just past week, there was another update to fix all the shit that they fucked up on the first update. And one of them was my issue. And I'm like, oh, fucking A. Let's do it. Right? So he does it, right? And I'm like, hey, it's still no service. It's like, all right, calm. He tells me, calm down. Relax, all right? We sir, got this.
Sir, please.
We got this.
Sir, don't raise your voice, please. Please.
Gregor Wanter, we got another torture in this building.
So, all right. Mm-hmm. So he's like, okay, how about we reboot, restore? I'm like, I already did that. He's like, oh, well, we should just try it again. I'm like, all right, let's do it again. All right? He takes me through the steps, right?
Yeah.
And he's on my computer. He's looking through my shit, you know, on the Apple thing, right? Mm-hmm. And he's seeing my thing, and he's like taking me through the steps, right? Mm-hmm. And he's all like, "This is protocol." And I'm like, "All right, fucking A, you know, we're going somewhere with this. Hallelujah, finally." He's all like, "Okay, you know, finish it up. I see it. It has service." And I'm like, "All right, you know, thank you. You helped me." He's all like, "Yes, great." That was the protocol for us to do. So, you know, hopefully everything goes well. Have a good day. So, you know, goodbye. And I'm walking around with my wife, telling my wife, hey, I got access now, you know? I can rock the world now, you know? With my knowledge through the phone of Apple.
Yeah.
Forbidden fruit. I know all now. Right? Fucking no service!
No, God! No, God, please, no! 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 No!
So to that, I give you a big fuck you to Apple. Fuck your knowledge. I don't want it anymore. No, I'm just kidding. I want it. I'll wait another week. That's what I gotta do.
Yeah, man. I thought you overcame your Apple race, but never mind. You didn't.
No, I didn't. No, I'm still fucked. Still no service.
I mean, you still went through some obstacles, though.
Yeah.
I am in no mood!
That's another thing, too. I told him, I'm like, so if this doesn't work, I get no service. So how am I gonna... So are you telling me that I have to walk around with no phone? And he's all like, well, you got Wi-Fi. It still works. That was his answer, bro. It's like,
no way!
As soon as I walk out of my house, I got no Wi-Fi. What say you to that?
They don't really know what they're doing, though.
No, they don't. And we got to move forward. I ruined all my music time for Apple.
But that was beautiful, though.
Thank you.
People want to know your story. People want to know the life of Shweddy.
You're not alone. If you're dealing with this, you're not alone.
On the podcast. Mm-hmm. You know? People are going to now want to know your update with the Spartan race. And people are going to want to know your update with your iPhone. They want to know. From this,
I wanna know.
From today till next week, they want to know what's keeping up with Shweddy.
Keeping up with the Shweddy. All right, keeping this week's Song Week is by a band called Nero. I talked about them last week saying dubstep.
You did?
It comes and goes. Mm-hmm. This dubstep's something fucking different, man. It's crazy. It's fucking nuts. The newest album is called Between Two Worlds. The song that I'm picking is the third song off of that, the fourth song off of that. It comes and it goes. All right? So please enjoy. I'd like to thank, or we would like to thank
everybody that's
everybody,
watching.
Everybody, yes. Everybody.
Everybody that didn't get scared that this was a Sanchless episode. And everybody that had confidence of... You know, Shweddy and I doing this episode.
Swanch. Sanch will be back next week.
He'll be back next week.
We'll be back to normal.
We'll hear what he ate today.
Yep.
We're going to find out all his tasty goodies.
So on and so forth.
Knowing him, he has a bunch of photos to share. You know?
Oh, tons, yes.
Yeah, tons of photos. That guy loves to take pictures.
We share.
So we share.
And make sure to catch us on Fridays with our top fives, all right? Go on rantradionetwork.com and see all our time slots. Don't forget my songs. Five of the week. You got it. It's Carlos's Five of the Week.
That's another episode in the bag. Thank you. Goodbye.